Evening, folks. R1 here. Today we're going to take a look at low-tier Russian tank gameplay. Specifically, we're going to start out with the BT-7 1937. If memory serves, I think this was my first match in this tank. Spotted an NPC tank and then a player tank coming at me over that hill. I've got some other enemies over to the left that I need to take out, or at least do some damage to. So I'm kind of exposing my position here a little bit, but yeah, what can we do? As it turns out, I jumped the gun a little bit and pay a price. I've already lost my loader. That's going to slow down my reload quite a bit. I realize I'm not going to be able to accomplish much unless I get over there and clear those guys off my flank. Well, at least now I know for sure that ghost shots do damage, and they can kill. Yeah, I did some damage, but again, I got tore up by incoming fire from that flank. That's the direction of their spawn, and they keep pouring out of there. They're starting to tick me off. Poking his head out again, trying to get in some good shots, but I'm a little too quick. My turret is turning very slowly right now, so I have to prepare before I engage this guy. Holy smokes, there's another one. They're just like rabbits boiling up out of that hole. I'm gonna swing in behind it. That slowed him down quite a bit, and he seems a little bit oblivious to my presence. I'm gonna have to make this next shot count. Good grief, I'm in trouble now. They're all over the place over here, all around this cap. So I'll get in the cap as quick as I can. And this is close. Oh well, gave him a good run. Now I'm looking for some payback. And I might get it now that I'm in a tank that's not full of holes. We're in trouble though. They've got three bases, although our boys are managing to start capping one of them. I'm gonna have to move fast. Seems there's quite the air battle going on overhead. Okay. My team got him, but my loader is dead again. Now we have got to capture this base, otherwise we're just delaying the inevitable. I know they're going to come for me here too, so I'm going to dig in as best I can, try and get in a good position. Fortunately, I've got some backup that's on its way. And I'm going to need them. This is going to get rough. Holy smokes, they're like cockroaches coming out of the woodwork. Now we've got two bases. The ticket counter is slowly going down for our opponents, but we're going to have to hold out for quite a while if we're going to pull this one out. I notice that the enemy is trying to retake A, so I position very quickly to try and take out the enemy tank. Our team gets him. And I decide I'm going to move into position. We have to recapture that base. We cannot afford to lose any ground at this point. And I have just spotted the last thing that I wanted to see. A German bomber coming in, HE-111. I take a pot shot, which may have been a bad idea. And he is coming directly for me. I'm a sitting duck on this base. But I have a little cover. Oh my god, that was close. That was pretty much right behind where I was sitting. I'm just glad this is a very quick and very nimble little tank. We take the base and it's time to move on to the next. This tank's ability to cover ground quickly is proving to be invaluable in this particular battle. My team has been a good one so far this match, and they have managed to retake the last base. We own them all. We just have to hang on to them now. So I'm going to use this tank's speed to patrol our other bases, and I'm going to start heading in sequence all the way across the map to our other base, just to make sure that we hang on to them. Now I had gotten about halfway across the map, most of the way toward our furthest base, when they start taking C again. So I race back through heavy, rough terrain and attempt to get back to the base before the balance shifts too far in their favor again. We don't have any time to play with here. And there's that guy. Got him a split second before my other teammate did. Sorry about that, buddy. And that's going to end up ending the match. We're going to camp here for a few, retake this base, and the ticket counter will go down fairly quickly after that. This match turned out pretty well for me. 6 kills, 4 assists, good rewards, ton of cool stuff. And I ended up unlocking most, if not all, of the mods for this tank. I think there might have been one or two who I didn't get this round. It was a fun match. This was a fun little tank. If you like a fast-moving combat style, this is a good way to go. So that's our look at the BT-7, showing you some of the advantages. Of course, its main advantage is that this tank is just a lot of fun to play. But it's also nice that it has an excellent line of progression, all the way down to the T-54 medium tank. For the next video in this series, we'll stick with the other offering in Battle Ranking 1.3, the T-60, which is a fun tank in its own right, although it has nowhere near as good a line of progression as you advance in rank. But that's okay, it more than makes up for it on its own merit. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please consider subscribing. And no matter what game you enjoy playing, or if it's War Thunder, no matter what vehicle you enjoy piloting on the ground or in the air, good hunting.